Hello friends, welcome to the official YouTube page of Everest IAS Academy. So today we are going to discuss March 15, 2020 Hindu newspaper analysis from the UPSC prelims 2020 point of view. So before going into the video friends, we are actually very happy to announce our next actually like India's national batch. Actually this is a batch we are exclusively starting only for UPSC prelims this year. So those candidates who are preparing for this year UPSC prelims 2020, we are actually planning to launch this Super 20 batch, and this batch starts from March 20th of this month friends. So for this batch actually like we are planning to take 20 online students. So basically friends, one more thing is regarding this batch actually like we are planning to avail this platform freely to the students, and through this platform only the first 10 candidates who are actually writing this examination, they will be given actually like 100% scholarship, and remaining students will be giving scholarship up to 50%. So friends, actually for this test actually like we are actually like asking candidates who are very much actually eligible, and they have covered the especially the static segments, they can take the test on 19th of this month. So basically friends, it will be an online test in which actually the questions will be basically coming from statics on mostly, and current affairs also will be included. It is a full length test. So those candidates who are good at that, we will be selecting those candidates, and as part of the Super 20 batch, we are planning to give 100% result in this actually batch friends. So those who are joining this particular batch, our target is actually we want all the students to clear this preliminary examination. In such a way, we are actually planning to take this course. So remaining information will be actually making this video into a PDF format, which will be available in our Telegram channel. So you can go and check this, and we will also coming up with a separate video regarding this particular course friends. So let's go into today's video. So the first article which came in the headlines is Mongoose Poached in Urban Tank in Coimbatore. So basically friends, articles like this are very much important for the environmental section of the current affairs segment. So basically friends, we have to understand the nature of the animal. The name is actually Indian Grey Mongoose. So basically this mongoose is why they are actually often in news, means they will be involved in, actually people will be involving in poaching activities, that is hunting activities. Why they are doing this means basically for its meat and fur. In addition to that, the skin upon that, it is having an hair like brush, and those brushes materials will be actually they are hunting those fur materials, and they are using for painting and other cosmetic brushes activities. So this is why they are actually doing this poaching activities. So in addition to that friends, even they are actually the brushes, that is the mongoose fur, which they are actually available on the skin surface, they are actually hunted, and they are actually taken and used in cosmetic and artist paints brush activities also. In India only, if you see friends, actually this Indian grey mongoose actually is very famous, and it is actually listed under Schedule 2 of the Indian Wildlife Protection Act 1972, and any person who is actually involved in poaching activities of this Indian grey mongoose will be actually like given 7 years of imprisonment, and even a hefty fine will be given. And one more thing is this Indian grey mongoose is also covered under our already the CITES convention, that is a convention regarding trading of endangered species of flora and fauna, that is plants and animals, and it is an international agreement, and its objective is to ban its commercial trade, especially the animals which has been listed under this convention. So in this also the CITES convention also this Indian grey mongoose is already listed. So one more thing is friends, regarding the UPSC preliminary examination, we should understand the basics of this Indian grey mongoose. So basically it will be found in the natives of areas of Western Asia as well as in the Indian subcontinent region. So one more thing is friends, one thing which we should understand is its IUCN status, which is actually listed as least concern. So this is actually very important for the UPSC preliminary examination. Next article is will work to restore Jammu and Kashmir statehood. So basically friends, this statement has been made by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. So actually like recently he met a party delegation, which was a newly formed party from Jammu and Kashmir, that is Apne party. So with him actually like the Prime Minister interacted, in that actually he made some statements regarding the future of statehood of Jammu and Kashmir. Because last year what happened was during the June month of 2019, the article 370, which was under which article like state of Jammu and Kashmir has been given special status. So as a statehood, it has been given a special status under article 370, and this status has been now revoked by the central government in last year, June 2019. Due to this, now Jammu and Kashmir has been actually like separated into two categories. One is the Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory, and then another is the Ladakh Union Territory. So as part of that only, actually there has been various demands from the people of Jammu and Kashmir to declare this Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory into an statehood. So for that also, our Prime Minister was very much actually like welcoming that particular measure. In addition to that, he has called for actually people's participation to emerge, especially in the Jammu and Kashmir, so that the democracy can be strengthened at the grassroots level. So in addition to that, friends, he also talked about the youth empowerment, because in case of India, especially in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, the problem is because of the ideology, the radicalism prevailing, and there is lot of uneducated youths who are not actually employable by the industries. So actually Prime Minister stressed upon providing them actually skilled development and creating employment opportunities, so that the youths can be actually de-radicalized also. So in addition to that, friends, actually Prime Minister also assured the delegation that center was actually very much actually focused upon the economic development of the state of Jammu and Kashmir, with major actually focus upon infrastructure development, in addition tourism activities also. Next article is MP's panel concerned at defense fund shortfall. So basically, friends, this is an article actually which is coming up on the background of recent Parliamentary Standing Committee on Defence. So this committee actually has submitted recently a report. In that, what it has highlighted is that every year in the budget actually there is a widening gap which is happening with respect to what the government is actually projecting and what is actually the allocation which has been made in the union budget. So there is a difference. Because of this actually difference in allocation of funding, actually this will affect the modernization as well as the liabilities and procurement of military infrastructure in the country. So in addition to that, friends, what is the committee actually, the standing committee has given some other guidelines also. What it is saying is that currently the situation is actually not conducive for the people of the country, because if you see, friends, there is actually like why this particular committee is stressing upon is that actually as a part of our nation building, we should have a credible deterrence. What do we mean by credible deterrence is that suppose other country is attacking India, means actually we should have at least a kind of defense infrastructure with us, such that we should be able to retaliate them at a successful level. This is the minimum deterrence level, they will say, in case of Army, Navy and Air Force. For that, processing and modern machinery defense infrastructure which are required, as part of that also our government should give more allocations for the defense. That is what this committee has suggested to the union government. So in addition to that, friends, next article is COVID-19 hurts textile exports. So basically, friends, the state of actually like especially the country of China, due to the recent novel coronavirus which happened in the Wuhan area, especially Hubei province of China, what happened is that most of the factories has been shut down. So due to this actually like China used to import lot of cotton yarns from other countries. So what it does is that, and it will actually, due to the major machinery infrastructure which have in its country, it was able to manufacture them into a high class textile products, and they were able to export across the countries. Now there is a lot of countries in the textile related infrastructure, they were actually lacking the kind of imports which they enjoyed from China, and this vacuum has actually left a huge space for even like countries like India to occupy that space. And this is what actually in the Indian industry is actually targeting with respect to that only this article is written. So what they are saying is that the supply chain is actually disrupted in the, especially in the textile sector, because with respect to China only, it used to import a lot of cotton yarn, mainly from China. It used to be a major importer. Other countries which used to convert this cotton yarn into textile products are Iran, Korea and as well as Vietnam. So next article is the global economy headed for recession. So basically, friends, this article is coming in the backdrop of recent novel coronavirus only, that is the COVID-19. So with respect to this novel coronavirus, its impact upon various industries in India, we have already discussed. One among the industries which we have already discussed in the agriculture is basically the pesticide industry will suffer, we have already said. And with respect to the pharma industries, already there is a less stockage of drugs we have in our country with respect to India. And this stockage because in medicine, while manufacturing drugs, we used to import a lot of these ingredients from the Chinese country only, and now actually we don't have the stocks to manufacture even normal diseases medicines like common cold and fever. And this will actually like the kind of stock which we are India is having now, it is now eligible to have this stock only for next 6 months. So there will be a chance for increase in rise of medicine prices in our country. And then in addition to that also, we have already discussed, reference the kind of impact it will have on the automobile sector. because what happens is that the kind of raw materials which India like imports, like engines and other automobile ingredients, everything has been imported from China only. Now due to this, even Indian automobile industry is suffering. And even in this article, we'll be discussing about the kind of impact it is happening upon the electronic industry, especially the mobile phone spare parts, which India used to import from China on a larger scale, and this used to be flooded in the Indian markets only. Due to this, our India has been suffering upon all this front. But there are some opportunities for India positively happening also, that also we have discussed. So due to the kind of vacuum which has been created by China in the international exports arena, it is leaving opportunities for emerging markets like India, especially to occupy in the various agricultural products, especially like around 21 agricultural products India can occupy positively, and now can actually like support, like supply the export to these countries also. And in addition to that, in textiles also actually we are having a major opportunity positively. So these are some of the advantages which we India enjoy also. With respect to that only, this article is written. But what this article the author is mainly discussing is, actually friends, if you see already the global world economic growth is already on a very moderate level. So basically, due to the recent novel coronavirus impact, because which has been recently declared as a pandemic, so the global, especially the economic growth has been affected. And many experts across the world, what they are saying, the economy will soon go into a state of recession. So what do we mean by recession is that any economy which is having two consecutive quarters of contraction, that is the reduction in GDP growth rate, if it is if it is consecutively declining, means then that economy is in a state of recession. Actually, Indian economy is also in a state of recession, but many experts are saying that, but our Indian government is actually saying that in an opposite stand, that there is a slowdown is happening. And friends, we should know what is the difference between slowdown and recession. Slowdown actually refers to the reduction in growth rate of the country, but in case of recession, there will be a reduction in growth rate. In addition, there will be an increase in unemployment. So these are the basic problems we will face. So in addition to that, friends, in case of China, as we have discussed already, Indian pharmaceuticals, automobile industries and then mobile phone industries, all these industries have been affected by, in case of India also, especially the pharma industry, for which India actually used to import 70% of its raw materials, have been affected now. And in short, actually in the medium term, India will suffer a increase in price of this pharma related medical products. In addition to that, friends, the novel coronavirus impact in the world also, because of that, lot of the aircraft, especially the flight tickets journey, has been affected. Many flights have been cancelled or terminated. So now what is happening is that actually the airport as an infrastructure and as a business, actually it is actually now occupying the total industry has been now greatly affected. In addition to that, the author is saying, in case of India, the shared mobility may be affected, because many of the cab drivers who actually like run in this novel coronavirus attack, actually like many people are in a state of home isolation or community isolation, and this is actually leading to reduction in usage of cabs in the country. This is actually what this particular author is saying. So this will even affect the life of a normal cab driver. For him, actually every day's life is dependent upon that particular day's money only. So in addition to that, what this particular author is saying is that in the medium term, there will be a rise in sale of medical supplies, especially soaps, sanitizers, and even the essentials like mask will be actually like, there will be a need for that. The product's demand will be rising. So because what this author is saying, when this SARS, that is a severe acute respiratory syndrome, which made its appearance in China in 2003, that time actually like the market which got boomed in China is only the online market. That time only the China's actually major billionaire, that is Alibaba, made its biggest fortune and became a billionaire due to this usage of this particular market, epidemic market, which was created in 2003. So what this author is saying, in India also there is a chance for digital booming to happen. So next article is, this is a science and technology article, friends. The time is right for one health science. So basically, friends, in this particular article, the author is talking about the new concept that is called one health science. So what do we mean by one health science? This author is saying is that, this author is actually stressing upon there should be a need for interdisciplinary approach. So basically, this interdisciplinary approach, in this expert should be coming across from various domains. So, and they should have an interaction. As part of that, they should do and research, and through that research, they should actually try to provide the linkage between biodiversity and human health. So this is the basic concept of one health science, which has been discussed in this article. So friends, if you see, basically the author is listing the example of Kerala model. So basically the novel coronavirus has been now impacted, and as of today there are 109 plus cases has been confirmed in case of India. And one more thing is, what every scholars across India they are saying as a solution to control this novel coronavirus is that we should go for a Kerala model, because in case of Kerala model we used to provide stronger actually like stress upon to strong public health infrastructure, and actually like there will be an interdisciplinary approach, and this is the approach which Kerala has followed during that 2018 Nipah virus outbreak. So basically this Nipah virus actually like it had its origin from fruit bat, that is a fruit bat, fruit flies are bat. From that it had its origin and spread to various other animals and humans also. That time actually Kerala like played very proactively at the lower level, district collectorate level only. Lot of autonomous powers has been given to make the decisions and solve the matter. And even various like there are lot of international experts who came and participated in that. So that also they will discuss. Let us go and discuss that, friends. So basically what this author is saying is that there should be actually an interaction between human health and then animal health as well as the environment. So this is the paradigm or concept of One Health this author is actually discussing. India has actually practiced this One Health science concept during the time period of Kyazuno forest disease or monkey fever, we call it is. This is the actually a blood loss fever, that is a hemorrhagic fever which had its origin from especially the monkeys, and then it got transferred to humans also. So that time actually like India made some of the interdisciplinary approach. That is, it made actually like involvement of crucial organizations like Rockefeller Foundation, and then Virus Research Center, and then National Institute of Virology Pune, and then WHO, and then Bombay Natural History. All these organizations, they actually came together and they did the interdisciplinary work. That's why it has been named as One Health Science. So this is what this author is saying. In case of India also, we should go for that. For that, our government has made one initiative that is called as National Mission on Biodiversity and Human Well-being. So the basic idea of this mission is actually what this author is saying is that there is actually currently we have explored the there is actually not a neglected links which is happening between biodiversity and human health as well as the animal health. So in case of this National Mission on Biodiversity, our government is stressing upon a crucial point, that is it actually explicitly links the biodiversity to human health in this One Health framework. So this in this government initiative also we can actually go and like accomplish the mission of One Health framework. So basically friends, as we have discussed, but for to accomplish this we should need the like coordination of government, private institutions, the two from various range of disciplines. So they have to come together and they have to sit and collaborate how they actually the zoonotic diseases actually like can emerge as a threat or spread, and how it can be controlled. This research has to be done, then only through the concept of One Health approach these new diseases like novel coronavirus can be tackled in future. So this approach will also leads to greater transparency and cross-country collaborations. This is one crucial thing in which experts across the world will come and sit together, and through that they will solve the crucial recent viruses which are happening around the world. Next article is heat stress may impact over 1.2 billion people annually by 2100 study. So basically friends, heat stress is a concept in which there is an increase in global temperature. Due to that actually it will have an impact upon not only humans, but it will also affect the animals as well as the various fields like agricultural health, economy, and then environment. So basically friends, one thing what this particular author is saying is that the stress from heat and humidity, so basically through this only actually like there will be around 120 crore people in the world will be getting affected by 2100. As of now in the world population is around 7.5 crore people are in the world. So in that what this particular author is saying is that 1.2 crore people only actually like they will get affected by 2100 due to the kind of the increase in temperature, especially the heat stress which is going to rise. So in addition to that, what this author is saying, the increase in heat will also affect the human's body's temperature, and it will affect the human brain and other vital organs of the body. So in addition to that, through the surveys and reports, what these authors are actually concluding is that if the planet continuously warms by 1.5 degrees Celsius, means there will be around actually 50 crore people who will be getting affected. So in addition to that, it will be actually like 2 degrees Celsius if the temperatures are increasing, means there will be around 80 crore people who will be getting affected. Thank you friends. If you like our videos, kindly subscribe to our channel, and if you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section.